Hey, Star Wars Action Figure Collectors, this is Darth Phoenix 619 coming at you with another review, and this time I have my first ever creature review. I don't collect Star Wars creatures. This is my first and only Star Wars creature in my collection, though I've always wanted to get the Geonosis monsters as well, the Nexu, the Acklay, and the Reek, but the Boga's always been one of my favorite creatures, along with the Tauntaun. It would be nice to get that guy too. And I saw this at a toy fair for $5. He tends to retail around $15 to $30. I think it's about $15, maybe even a little bit cheaper, loose. And if you want him in package, it's somewhere around $25 to $30. If I remember correctly online, he was found in the 2005 Revenge of the Sith line. And I think he actually came with an Obi-Wan. He did not come with this Obi-Wan. This is one of the episode 3 Obi-Wan from the vintage collection. So I just kind of want to show you what he looked like with a figure on top of him. That one does not have ball hinge hips, so he's kind of off the seat a bit. But, you know, with a figure, especially an Obi-Wan that has ball hinge hips, I think would fit really good on there. So I decided, you know, to do a review on a creature. So why not? So let's go ahead and take off Obi-Wan and take a good look at him. Now, for what it is, this guy has an amazing sculpt and amazing paint apps. Really where he lacks is the articulation. I mean, he is an older figure. He does lack some articulation. So he's pretty long. He's probably about a foot long or so. And I can't even get him in the entire in the entire scope of the camera. So I'll just kind of move him around a bit. But let's go ahead and take a close look at his head sculpt first. So, like I said, the thing that stands out really the most besides the sculpt is his paint apps, and I think they did a wonderful job. I really like the different shades of green that you see here, and then you see some black shading, some wash over, especially here in the neck. This is a softer plastic, and there's a reason for that. I'll show you guys in a second. But, you know, his eyes look good. Really like the beak on this guy. It just looks great. I mean, wonderful, wonderful articulation. And then inside of his mouth, you see it's pink. You got the tongue in there. That's nicely sculpted. So, you know, it doesn't open and stay open just by manipulating here. I'll show you how that works in a sec. So just really soft plastic. Reminds me of my bearded dragon right there. I mean, like, pretty realistic. You know, gives it a little bit more realism. The fact that they use a softer plastic there, kind of a rubber. Then you see some detail here on the legs, on the feet, the scales, different shades of green. Looks really good. Some more. It's kind of shininess to it. Almost like real scales on a green reptile. Then you got the saddle, which, once again, beautifully sculpted. The paint gives it a very leather look to it, very realistic. And like I mentioned, the figure does fit pretty well in there. Seems, there we go, a little paint. Who knows where, but it's a little softer plastic. So, just really beautiful, you know, worn look right there. You got the stirrups, the action figure's feet. There's the hind legs. And then you've got this long tail, which is a bendable plastic, but it doesn't stay in place, doesn't have that wire. That would have been nice if they had the wire in here to kind of let you pose it in more different ways. But, you know, soft plastic there. I think these are feathers on the Boga. I mean, they look like feathers. I'm pretty sure they're feathers, so that's really sculpted nicely, too. And it just looks really good. I mean, I really, really, really like this figure. And it displays well with Obi-Wan. Underneath, if you own a reptile, you're... Well, besides the fact that it says Hasbro here, I mean, this looks like the bottom of my reptile. I mean, just really realistic. Just looks fantastic. Okay. So, as for articulation, you've got some articulation here on the legs. It's not really a 360. Oh, yeah, I guess it is. It's pretty tight, though. So, that goes 360. And then, see these bits here? You can move them kind of back and forth. Can move the neck back and forth, but that's pretty much, I mean, it doesn't stay in place as with the beak. Here's what the gimmick is. So What you do is you pull on the tail like this. Let me just get that to focus for you guys. And what it does is it opens up his mouth and the front legs go up. So you can, and you can see there's a little bend here at the neck. And that's its gimmick. I mean, I guess it works. You know, I definitely would have preferred some regular articulation, you know, here on the mouth and the neck, on the front legs, and a bendable wire on the tail. But I guess for the time being, they really wanted to appeal to kids and have that little play feature. So there it is again. But all in all, this is a great, great creature. I mean, if you collect creatures and you don't have this guy in your collection, it's a definite must. And if you've ever thought about buying any creatures, I'd highly recommend the Boga. Really cool. Alright, so there you guys have it. So until next time, please comment, rate, subscribe. You guys know the drill. And may the Force be with you.